Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today we are doing my 2022 planner and journal lineup. I only have three things, but I'm super excited to show you all because I kind of just set them up recently. So yeah, let's just get right into it. The first thing, let's talk about my journals for the year. Okay, so I have two journals for the year. I have a reading journal and my regular daily journal. You guys have seen lots of videos on my daily journal throughout the year, and I just uploaded a video on how I set up my reading journal, so I'm not gonna go too in-depth with it. But first, let's talk about my daily journal. You guys know that I love keeping a daily journal. I completed 21 so far. So this is number 22, which is crazy that we're starting year 2022 with my 22nd journal. But yeah, I'm super excited to use it. This is a Paper Shire journal. This is the vanilla star design. It's black, has a little gold vanilla here with some stars. Very appropriate for the name. It has 160 GSM paper, and yeah, I'm super excited to use this. I've used one of her bullet journals so far as my regular daily journal. It was journal number 11, I believe. So if you want to check out the flip through, it is already up on my channel. But yeah, I'm super excited to use this. I've set it up, and there will be a video going up on how I set up this journal, but not for a while. So I'll just do a quick flip through for you guys. We have a card here in the front, another card here, another card here. Here's my cover page. Well, I haven't started this yet while I'm filming this video, but I will be starting this journal on January 1st. Love this cover page. And then I put this card here that says, "What if you simply devoted this year to loving yourself more," which I thought was super appropriate. There's something stuck on here. Okay. Originally this said 2020, but I just covered it with a sticker that said 2022 for obvious reasons. And then, excuse me, on this page, I used these little printouts and made a cover page for January 2022. I think it turned out super pretty. I'm really happy with it. And then I have a little quote here that says, "Whither thou goest, I will go," which is a quote from the Shadowhunter world. And yeah, super pretty. I love the colors, love the travel theme, even though we likely won't be doing a lot of travel in 2022. I just thought it was super cute. So this is my journal where I will be doing bookish spreads, daily spreads, any sort of miscellaneous catch-all things in here. If you want to see how I've used my daily journals in the past, I have a whole list of flip-throughs, which you can find on my channel, and I'll try to remember to link it down below. But yeah, there's lots of pages here, and I'm just super excited to fill them all up. And yeah, that is my daily journal. I will also show you guys a few of the journals, the blank journals that I'm planning on using this year. You guys probably know that I go through a lot of journals every year, so I have to have lots of options. The first one I have here is one of these faux wood grain journals. You guys have seen these probably like hundreds of times on my channel. I'm just trying to make sure everything is aligned, but yeah, I'm super excited to use this. These are from the dollar store. They're $3.50, have 192 pages. The paper is pretty great quality, so yeah, excited to use this. You'll definitely see a setup video, actually maybe not definitely, but you'll probably see a setup video for whenever I use these journals. Next, I have this Pantone journal. I got a pack of three from Costco, and I really want to use at least one this year. These are super pretty. They have some text on the inside and lots of pages for me to fill up, and also it comes with some stickers in the back, and I have no idea how I'm going to use these, but I think they're super cute. Anyway, here's the green one. I also have a black and an orange one, but I really like the green color, so I'll probably use this one first. Moving on, I got this journal when I went on my trip to Montreal. I kind of got it as a souvenir. This has 144 lined pages, and it's just a florally journal. It has pink on the inside, and then lots and lots of pages once again for me to fill up. And actually, this paper, it's pretty good quality. Like, it's pretty thick, so I'm super happy with that. Anyway, I'm excited to use this. I'll probably use it sometime in the spring, maybe like May. It's giving me May vibes. And yeah, so really excited to use that. And lastly, I want to show you these journals. If you've watched any of my travel journal flip-throughs, these will probably look familiar to you. I had to get two packs of these. It was a long story, but basically I got one pack, and then the second pack was free and it came with it. So I kept the other three, and I've designated these as my travel journals. The next time I go on a trip, I'll probably cover up the cover so it looks a little bit different than my past journals. But yeah, it comes in a pack of three, and I'm super excited to use these in the new year. Assuming I do any sort of travel, but anyway. Next I have my reading journal. So my last upload before this one should have been my reading journal setup. And this is again a Paper Shire bullet journal, same details as everything above. This is just the teal bow design, super pretty. I'm actually obsessed with it. Yeah, so here is my cover page. I'll just do a quick flip through just so you guys can kind of tell how I set it up. Here's my cover page, more cover page, this quote that I hand lettered reading journal. This is also from Paper Shire. A lot of stickers here are from My Shop Parchment and Pens. And yeah, so we have my book count goal. Drawing these squares took forever. My favorite book of the month, anticipated releases, my alphabet challenge, wish list received, and books bought. And then we have my January cover page, and then I still haven't set up the rest of the spreads, but hopefully I'll be able to do that soon. Regardless, I'm super excited. If you want to see a more in-depth flip through, definitely check out my upload before this one. Also, I do want to mention that this is the first year that I've ever kept a reading journal. In the past, I did always write the books that I read down, and I started adding them onto a Goodreads list, but I started adding them to my Goodreads list, but I noticed that I didn't have anywhere to write them down physically this year, and I didn't want to do it in my regular journal, so I decided, why not keep a reading journal? I'm super excited. Hopefully this turns out well. And yeah, definitely keep an eye on my channel for flip-throughs throughout the year. Okay, last thing that I do want to share is my planner. Also, as you can probably tell, I'm actually not big on, planning ahead. If I need to do any of those things, I usually just make a to-do list on my laptop or on my phone. But this is kind of all just for, memories and stuff and, my crafty, pretty things. Anyway, this is a Recollections Memory Planner. It's a vertical style. It was originally a 2021 to 2022 planner, but I made these little vinyl decals to cover it up so it just says year 2022, and I ripped out all the pages for 2021 just so it wouldn't take up unnecessary space. Again, this is a Recollections Planner from Michaels. I got it on sale. Actually, my sister got it on sale for me at the end of the year, since it also had 2021 in it. They were trying to get rid of it, which is great for me because I just needed it for 2022. Here I have a little charm from the Coffee Monsters Co. I think it's so cute. I was gifted this and I thought I would just make a little addition right here on the coil. Anyway, I will give you guys a quick flip through of how this planner looks. I just want to make sure it's in the middle. There we are. Of course, it still says 2021, 2022 here. Not a big deal. We have the calendar pages, whatever. It came with these stickers, which I probably won't be using in this planner, except maybe some of these emojis, which I think are super cute. And then it also came with a piece of wax paper where you can stick on your stickers and peel them off easily. Came with a little pocket. And I did keep December inside the planner because I needed the last week of December, which I've already started to plan out. This is a printable sticker kit. I think it turned out super pretty. I love the vibes of it. You'll see that this is actually the same art that I used in my regular journal for the cover page. Let me just flip it open. There, as you can see, it's the same girl because I accidentally printed it the wrong size, so I just didn't want to waste it, so I cut it out and put it in my regular journal. Anyway, here's my planner spread, and then we have the next month, which is January. There's a monthly calendar at the front of every month, but I probably won't be using it, to be honest. And then I started setting up some of the weeks for after that. So we have the first week of January, or first full week of January. I have this gorgeous kit. I think it was called White Winter. Super pretty. Again, from Pink Planner Shop. And then I set up my week after that, which is using this Aurora kit. Again, from Pink Planner Shop. Super pretty. I just think it's so cute. I love it. Okay. Anyway, I haven't done the rest of the weeks, but that's just basically how every month goes. We have a, dashboard, and then we have the monthly, and then a bunch of weeklies. I think that's all. I actually haven't looked at the back of this planner. I think it's just a bunch of note pages. Yeah. So at the back, you just have a bunch of note pages. You actually have quite a few, which is nice. I don't know what I'll be using these for. I probably won't even use them. But yeah, that is my memory sticker planner for this year. Super pretty. So obsessed with it. And with that, that is the end of this video. That is my planner and journal lineup for the year of 2022. I'm super excited to fill all of these up, and I will for sure be doing flip throughs of all of them at the end of the year. If you guys enjoyed, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!